behind us there?
Welcome. Thank you, everyone, for being here today. Quick shout out. Doc's not with us. He had a long planned trip out of the country, but I know he's watching, and I know he's really excited about this announcement. Kind of starting with the winter and our internal meetings, and as we were getting together and talking about ways that we could put ourselves in the best position to win a World Series in 2025, all conversations kept coming back to Blake. Known him since he was 18 years old, and to watch his journey, watch the incredible success that he's had, has been really special. And with a guy that's enjoyed that much success, usually in Major League free agency, you're buying the backside of a guy's career, the accomplishments that they have had. And with Blake, one thing that's really exciting for us is as much success as he's had, we feel like there's more in there and a lot of upside that beyond what he's done to this point and the impact that can have on us and our quest to win a World Series this year and as many years as we can see out. Looking back over the years, we've competed against Blake a lot, and you know how the old adage, if you can't beat him, just have him join us. So we couldn't beat him, so we're going to have him join us in helping us win a World Series next year and into the future. So with that, it is our pleasure to introduce the newest member of the Dodgers, Blake Snell.
You're good. It's too good to take off.
So with that, we'll kick it to Q&A and let you guys.
Yeah, Blake, this is Jim Hill, KCAL9 News here in Los Angeles. First of all, congratulations and good luck. How difficult or how easy a decision was this for you to make?
Yeah, it was really easy. Just because me and Haley wanted to live here. It's something we've been talking about for a while. And then you look at the team, you look at what they've built, what they're doing. It's just something you want to be a part of. I mean, look at the first three hitters in the lineup. It's tough to go against. So to be on the other side, know that they're going to be, you know, hitting for me. Yeah, pretty exciting.
Hey, Blake, welcome to the Dodgers. Are you friendly with any of the current players? And if so, have you spoke to anybody?
Yeah, I've talked to some of the pitchers. I never really talked to position players a lot. Just pass by, say hi, stuff like that. But when you got to compete against them, you got to have an edge. So I'm sure we'll start talking and become friends and family. So we'll get there.
Andrew, you guys obviously spent a lot last winter. You win the World Series. Like, how much does the idea of trying to repeat, trying to cement a dynasty, like all that narrative stuff, kind of factor in to decisions like this? And like you talked about with Blake specifically, what kind of made him a key piece as you guys look towards next year to trying to win again?
From our standpoint, each and every year, we're trying to win, and it's hard. And what's really difficult is to win. What's even harder to do is to repeat. And to a man, all the guys that we've talked to, of our players, coaching staff, everyone is of the mind of, let's run it back. Let's do everything we can to be in position to win. you know, we feel like we've got a really talented team in place. So everything for us was centered around what can we do, what can we add to put ourselves in the best position to do that. You know, we've talked about from a big picture standpoint, a goal being that we want to look back on this period of time as the golden era of Dodgers baseball. That's a high bar, and you know, for us to continue to do everything we can to win is really important, and adding someone with Blake's ability to compete, you know, what he'll bring to our staff, we felt like was an incredibly impactful move in that. You know, again, he's had a tremendous amount of success to this point, winning two Cy Youngs. But again, we feel like there's potentially even more in there, which is not often something you can say with a guy that's had the success that he's had. We spent time a couple of weeks ago meeting with Blake and Scott and just talking through things, and just the continued maturation, the continued development, you know, his strong desire to win and to be great, and how well that fits in within our culture. We felt like this was a perfect match in a lot of ways, and we're excited to get to work with him and work together and try to win as many games as we can.
Yeah, Andrew, just to kind of follow up on that, how unique of a financial position are you guys in just to be able to win the World Series, spending the amount that you did last offseason, and still be able to operate at the top of the market and sign a two-time Cy Young winner, sort of this winter?
Yeah, I mean, as long as I've been here now going into year 11, the commitment from our ownership group to do everything we can to win has been there time and time again. Last offseason, very clear direction. Let's continue with what we've built. Let's be aggressive. And that message has continued. And it's easy for people to say, and I think you can go back and look at the demonstrated commitment that our ownership group has made and is going to continue to make for us to do everything we can to win as many championships as we possibly can.
Yeah, Blake, how different were the two experiences in free agency for you last year and this, and how much did last year's experience maybe motivate you to make a quick decision this year?
I don't know if it motivated me. I definitely, it's up to the teams. You know, like last year I would have wanted to sign quicker, but teams weren't interested at that time. So it's up to the teams. But for me, you know, I was excited with what I did last year, signed that deal. And then coming into this free agency, I knew I put myself in a good position to sign earlier. And with how aggressive Andrew was and Brandon, it made it pretty exciting pretty quickly. And I'm just happy we were able to get something done and really looking forward to being here for 5 years.
Blake, how much did the second half show you how higher the bar can go for you?
Yeah, I mean, I think the first half's kind of, you know, of this year, I learned a lot. You know, I was trying to push through some things to see, you know, where I was, how I can get better. Failed, and from that point moving forward, it really helped me. Like, I need to take a little more time. I need to feel a certain way. And once I got in a rhythm, usually when I get in a rhythm, I could really, you know, take that the rest of the season. So just learning through those first two hiccups. And then as I started end of June, early July, somewhere in there, I was really confident from my rehab starts going into that, where I was like, okay, I'll be able to kind of take this all the way and start dominating.
Blake, David Vasse, AM570.
Dave.
Just wanted to ask you, usually when a team signs a pitcher of your caliber, they're trying to get over the hump. This team just won the World Series. How do you fit into all that, and what's that feeling for you to join a world champion?
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun to know that you got a team full of experience. Them winning the World Series it puts you in a position, just being able to go through that. That team went through something that, you know, no one gets to go through. And being able to learn from that, I'm excited. I've been there, but I failed. They've been there, and they succeeded. So being able to see what that's like, hear it from them, and then also, you know, hopefully help them with just the hunger of wanting to do this every year, win World Series after World Series. That's why we all play. It's what makes the off season worth it, is to get to the playoffs. It's what makes the whole season worth it. So for me, pushing forward, it's just do what I can do to help the team win World Series, to get to positions to just get to the playoffs. That's hard by itself, too. So I'll be looking forward to it.
Yeah, Blake, over here. How much does Game 6 of the 2020 World Series stick with you as a motivating factor?
I don't know if it's a motivating factor. It was a moment in my life that I'm very appreciative of, and everything happened for a reason. Now to be on the flip side, I'm beyond excited. This team's stacked top to bottom with youth, too. Can't wait to teach, you know, the young pitchers just what has helped me along the way, and hopefully it can help them. I don't look into that game as much as everyone else. It was just a moment in time that I learned from. And, I mean, I told Andrew if I wanted to stay out there longer, I should have done a better job before that game to make that decision easier on Kevin. So it's ultimately up to me to be a better pitcher to earn that moment.
Yeah, a question for anybody. Andrew, you said that you feel confident that you're not paying for quote-unquote back end of a career. What is it about Blake specifically, his repertoire, anything that makes you feel like these next 5 years could be some of his best?
Obviously watching Blake from the other side and having conversations with him, I think the dedication to taking care of his body, to game planning, and, you know, what really stood out is just the hunger to learn at every step. So when you have that, you know, those intangibles along with an incredible amount of talent, those are easy things to bet on moving forward. And feeling like getting in our culture and with our coaches and you know, staff, it's going to help really raise it to another level, because Blake is ready to go ahead and fully immerse himself in that. So we couldn't be more excited about it.
Hey, Blake, right here. Fredo Cervantes with the Sporting Tribune. You know, welcome to Los Angeles, by the way, and happy early birthday.
Thank you.
You know, you played in this division for the past few years here, one in San Francisco, a few in San Diego. What ultimately intrigued you to make the decision quicker this year? And, you know, what do you love about this team?
Yeah, I mean, being in L.A., that, you know, the pressure's always on. I like that. Living here is pretty amazing, opportunities. But being able to pitch in a packed stadium, you know, get to make moments for people, and this is where you want to play. I don't think there's a better situation that you could be in than being right here. And then knowing Andrew how much, as well as I know him, that played a big part. It all started because he believed in me, so I couldn't see a better reason not to come here. And the goal is to end it here, so see how long I could push my career for and see how many World Series we can win.
Welcome to L.A., Blake. There's some talk about going to a six-man rotation next season. So I want to get your thoughts on the possibility of pitching in a six-man rotation, if those were at all part of the discussions.
Let's get the spring training, meet the team, see how everything works out. We'll kind of go from there. I pitched on six-man rotation, five-man. I pitched on four-man rotations. I'm good with it all. As long as we have a plan, we'll execute it, and I'm good with it.
Blake, what do you look forward to the most playing for Dave?
I think first meeting him, talking to him. I've talked to him as a friend, but, you know, now is him being my manager. I think the biggest thing is just learning him, his style, what he's going to expect from me every day. I think those are the big things. A lot of what going into this is I got to, you know, it's new relationships. I got to meet people. I got to invest in people. They got to understand me. I got to understand them. That's kind of how I'm going to get the best version of me here. So spring training, even leading up to spring training. It's really understanding people, investing in the people, them investing into me, and then from there we'll figure out, you know, what the season's going to be like, all that. Right now I'm just going to get ready for spring, be the best version of me going into that, and then from there, you know, kind of learn my way as time takes.
Blake, welcome to LA.
Thank you.
Having Shohei Ohtani in this team, how much of that motivate you?
I mean, it helps with him in the lineup for sure. Yeah, that's big motivation. I just think the team in general, though, the team's so good. It's sound. They enjoy playing the game together. It makes you want to be a part of that and help. But with Shohei, the name, everything he's done in his career, it's amazing. And you want to be around players like that when you're trying to be one of the best in the game. So quite a big part.
Yeah, Blake, what made you want to defer money in your contract? And as a player, like, as you're sort of evaluating present money versus maybe later down the line, what are some of the things that you're kind of evaluating in that process?
I mean, I think it's just how it all played out. It just played out the way that people around me felt comfortable with, I felt comfortable with, they felt comfortable with. We talked, found something that could work for both of us, and it's kind of how we went with it. But yeah, I'm more focused on playing than money. The money is, you know, you want your worth, you want your respect, and you want an amount of time to where you can really, you know, make a name for yourself. I've made a name for myself, you know, outside of LA, but I'm gonna be invested to make one in it.
Blake, just wondering, any reason why you chose number 7 to wear?
Number 4 was taken.
Forever?
Yeah, okay, yeah. So 7, yeah. I wore it last year. I liked it, so, yeah. Thank you,
guys.
Perk, thank you.
Thank you, guys.